Hello students, in this video we'll solve example 16 from complex number. The last example of complex number but very important example. Let us see the question. Example 16, convert the complex number into polar form. Here we need to convert the given complex number into polar form. See students, to convert any complex number into polar form, the first step is we need to get the given complex number in standard form. That is A plus IB form. First, we need to convert the given complex number into standard form, that is A plus IB form. After we convert this into the standard form, then we convert it into polar form. Now, what is the polar form of complex number? Z is equals to R cos theta plus I sin theta. And to convert to the polar form, we will need to find the value of R and theta. And after we find the value of R and theta, we put the values here and we get the polar form of a complex number. Very simple. The problem is a bit lengthy, but you only have to do so much. That is, first convert the given complex number into standard form and then find the value of R and theta and put the value of R and theta in this equation. As simple as that. So let us start. Let's pick the given complex number, that is z is equals to I minus 1 by cos pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 3. So what is cos pi by 3? Cos 60. And sin pi by 3 is sin 60. Let us put the value of cos 60. Cos 60 is what? 1 by 2. And sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Now here, the denominators are same, we can add the numerator. As the denominators are same, we can directly add the numerators, that will be I minus 1 by 1 plus I root 3 by 2. Correct. Next, when we want to take this term in the numerator, this term becomes reciprocal. That is, this term becomes upside down. That is, I minus 1 into 2 by 1 plus I root 3. This term becomes the reciprocal. Next, let us multiply this. That is, 2 times I minus 1 is 2 times I minus 1 divided by 1 plus I root 3. Then multiply the brackets, that is 2I minus 2 by 1 plus I root 3. But we cannot have the iota in the denominator. In order to remove the iota, that is I, from the denominator, we will need to rationalize it. How do we rationalize? 1 plus I root 3. We take the 1 minus I root 3 and multiply and divide. See here, 2i minus 2 by 1 plus I root 3. I take the conjugate of it and multiply and divide. Next, multiply the terms. Then what you get is, multiply 2i into this term and next multiply negative 2 into this term. And 1 plus I root 3 gets multiplied to 1 minus I root 3. 2i times 1 is 2i and 2i times I root 3 is negative 2i square root 3 and negative 2 times 1 is negative 2 and negative negative will be positive and 2 times I root 3 will be 2i root 3 and the denominator here we can solve using this identity, that is this, the denominator is in the form of x plus y and x minus y, isn't it? So we can solve using this identity and we can write it in the form of x square minus y square. So this denominator will be 1 square minus I root 3 whole square. Next, let us split this. That is, I root 3 whole square will be I square and root 3 whole square. Now we can put the values of I square. So put the values of I square, that is negative 1, the I square is negative 1 and I square is negative 1. So what we get is 2i and negative, negative will be positive, that will be 2 root 3 and negative 2 and positive 2i root 3 by 1, that is 1, and negative, negative will be positive and the square and root get cancelled here and what remains is 3. Next, we can see 2 is common in all the terms here. We can take 2 as common. Let us take 2 common and what remains is I root 3 negative. 2 is already taken common, so what remains is 1 and plus 2 is taken common outside and what remains is I root 3 by 1 plus 3 is 4. Next, 2 times 1 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4. And let's separate the imaginary and the real terms also. Let us separate this. This is the real terms and these are the imaginary terms. So next we can take the common I, we can take common from this term, that will be, if we take I common, that will be 1 plus root 3. So now we can split it as real terms and the imaginary term. See, this is the real part, that is root 3 minus 1 by 2 is the real part, and this is the imaginary part, that is I, and root 3 plus 1 by 2. So now this is in the form of a plus ib. This is in the standard form of the complex number, isn't it? Yes. So now this is a plus I and b. After we convert it into the standard form, what is the next step? Next step is to convert it into polar form. What is the polar form? Z is equals to r cos theta plus I sin theta. For that, we need the value of r and theta. So let us find the value of r and theta. So this is the standard form of the given complex number, and to find the value of r, we have the formula r is equals to root of a square plus b square. Put the value of a, that is root 3 minus 1 by 2, and as we have square here, we write the square, plus put the values of b, that is root 3 plus 1 by 2, and the square is here, that's why square here. Next, let us split the brackets, that is root 3 minus 1 whole square, and 2 square will be 4, plus root 3 plus 1 whole square, and 2 square will be 4. Now as the denominator is same here, we can directly add the numerator. So let us add the numerator, that will be root 3 minus 1 whole square plus root 3 plus 1 whole square by 4. Now we can split this using the identity a minus b whole square and a plus b whole square, like this. Okay, split this using a plus b, a minus b whole square identity and a plus b whole square identity. So what we get is this. So now here you can see the negative and the positive term, which are similar. So negative 2 times root 3 times 1 and positive 2 times root 3 times 1 gets cancelled. These two terms get cancelled, and the square and root here gets cancelled. The square and root here also gets cancelled. And so what remains is 3 plus 1, and here 3 plus 1. That is 3 plus 1 plus 3 plus 1 by 4. So now when we add this, what we get is 8 by 4. So 4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8. So the r is equals to root 2. So the value of r is root 2. Next, let us find the value of theta. As we have the different values of theta in the different quadrant, so to choose the value of theta, we need to go back to the variable and we need to see the sign of the variable. So here the a is positive and b is also positive. So the positive and positive, it lies in the first quadrant. So the value of theta will be equals to alpha. So we pick this, the value of theta is equals to alpha. Now what is alpha? We don't have the value of alpha. So let us find alpha. Alpha is equals to tan inverse b by a. And this is a and this is b. So let us put the value of a and b here. As the value of a and b is a bit large, let me solve b by a separately and let me get back to you. So let's solve b by a. What is the value of b? Root 3 plus 1 by 2. And what is the value of a? Root 3 minus 1 by 2. So put the values here and what we get is root 3 plus 1 by root 3 minus 1. What can we do with this? If we take common, if we take root 3 common, what will remain is 1 plus 1 by root 3 by 1 minus 1 by root 3. So root 3, it gets cancelled. Here, I think we can convert this into a tan formula, the tan of a plus b formula. I'll show you how. See, the tan 1, 1 is nothing but tan pi by 4, isn't it? The value of tan pi by 4 is 1. And 1 by root 3 is tan pi by 6. The value of tan pi by 6 is 1 by root 3. So now to convert it into this formula, we need 1 here, isn't it? So we'll keep this 1 as it is here. And the tan b will be tan pi by 6. And we need tan alpha also. Tan beta is tan pi by 6. And we need here alpha also. And to get here alpha, we can write tan pi by 4. The value of tan by 4 is nothing but 1. So it is like multiplying 1 to tan pi by 6. Isn't it? See, the value of 1 by root 3 is tan pi by 6. It is like we are multiplying 1 to the value of tan pi by 6. See, we get this in this form, that is tan alpha plus tan beta by 1 minus tan alpha into tan beta. So we can write this in the form of tan alpha plus beta. So we can write this now in the form of tan alpha plus beta, that will be tan pi by 4 plus tan pi by 6. And when we add this, what we get is tan 5 pi by 12. So the value of b by a, the modulus b by a is tan 5 pi by 12. So let us put this value in that equation. So the value of modulus b by a, we have solved it as tan 5 pi by 12. Put the value of b by a here, that is tan 5 pi by 12. So the tan inverse and tan, it gets cancelled, and what we get alpha is equals to 5 pi by 12. So the value of alpha is 5 pi by 12. So let us put this value here, that is theta is equals to 5 pi by 12. Now we got the value of r and we also got the value of theta. So now what we have to do? We have to pick the polar form of the complex number, that is z is equals to r cos theta plus I sin theta, and put the value of r and theta. The value of r is root 2 and the value of theta is 5 pi by 12, and here also the value of theta is 5 pi by 12. So this is only the polar form of the given complex number, and here b by a, instead of solving all the b by a, let me quickly tell you shortcut of b by a. Suppose if you put the values of b and a here, that is root 3 plus 1 by root 3 minus 1. As we are dividing this, the 2 and 2 here will get cancelled. So what will remain is root 3 plus 1 and root 3 minus 1. So the tan inverse of root 3 plus 1 and root 3 minus 1 will always have the value 75, the 75 degree. That is 5 pi by 12 is nothing but 75 degree. If you want, you can remember the shortcut of this. Otherwise, you can solve the way I did. So that's all, students. If you have any questions, please ask me in comments. Thank you.